Hello everyone. Okay, this video I'm going to show you the strain calculation. Okay, and strain calculation. First of all, we start with the example with the normal strain calculation. Okay, and the definition of strain, I don't want to stress this anymore because the definition of strain actually is very easy. Okay, it's just your deformation divided by your original length. That's called normal strain. Okay, if you apply a material, stretch material, you have deformation delta. Okay, that's the difference between your the length of the material after deformation and your L naught or L zero. That means your length of the material before deformation and divided by your original length. That's called normal strain. Okay, and here we show a normal strain problem. And during this normal strain calculation, I also want to mention something to you. Okay, when you do one, when you do the norm strain calculation, you have to be careful. Okay, especially the digit. Okay, especially the decimal point in your calculation. Okay, and so here is a two wires. I think it's a thin wires. Okay, and connect to by connect as fixed on BC and connect to A. Okay, and it give you the information of these two strain. Okay, sorry, that's the geometry information of the two wires. Okay, and then he pull the wires and then he apply external loading. So he pull the wire AC to A prime C. Okay, and give you the information of the deformation. So is one the problem want to example want to calculate the normal strain, or the normal strain of AC and normal strain of AB. Okay, and for this problem, yeah, we need to do we have to draw the scheme. Okay, because this the problem is yeah, it's I think it's too small. It's hard to see the deformation. So we have to do exaggerate the picture. But when we exaggerate the picture, maybe it's not looks very physical. Okay, physical meaning. But for your understanding, I still have to do it in very exaggerate weight. Okay, so at the beginning, the geometries look like this. Okay, so there's a two wire connect to get a two wire connect together, and here is 3 meter, here is 4 meter, here's a 4 meter. Okay, and after the external loading P, pull AC to A prime C. Okay, what does it look like? Okay, it looks like this. It pull in this way. I believe it's this way. Okay, I believe this way. And okay, so let's make a okay, it will look like this. Okay, not very physically true, but you will pull, I think, let me try. Okay, so you pull it this way. Okay, here and then here is B, this is C, and here is A prime. Okay, it doesn't look very like the real situation, but that's because for your honor. Okay. I think that's after the deformation. Okay. So you want to calculate the strain of AC wire and strain normal strain of AB wire. Okay. And normal strain is very easy. We have to calculate the delta. Okay. So, what's the delta AB? Actually is equal to A prime B length of A. Sorry, length of A prime B and minus the length of AB. And the other one is the strain A prime C, or strain AC. Okay, actually is A prime C. Okay, I keep saying delta strain. Okay, the deformation of AB. Okay, deformation of AB is A prime B minus AB, and deformation of AC is A prime C minus AC. Okay, so the string AB is just the delta AB divided by length AB. Okay, and the strain AC is just the deformation AC divided by length AC. Okay, and the length AB and AC is original length. Okay, original length is very easy because this is a right triangle. So the length of AC equal to length AB is just equal to, okay, just use this law. Okay, I forgot how to use the English to say this rule. Okay, the Pythagoras, Pythagoras theorem. Okay. Okay, 勾股定理. Okay, so you will say AC and AB is 5. Okay, don't forget this, it's unit is it's meter. Okay, and next problem is we have to calculate deformation of AB and AC. Okay, the deformation of AB is AB prime minus AB. Okay, so what is A prime B? Okay, we start with the AC first. Okay, we start with AC first. Okay, let me see. Okay, we start with AB. Okay, never mind. Okay, I start with AB first. Okay, let's start with AB. Okay, AB, A prime B. So we need to find the length of A prime B. Okay, A prime B. Okay, so the deformation information here, he say this is what is deformation here? He say it's 20 millimeter. Okay, and deformation here is 10 millimeter. Okay, so we want to calculate length of A prime B. So how do we calculate? Okay, so we draw another axial line. Okay, here. Okay, so how do we calculate A prime B? So first of all, okay, what the length here? Okay, here is 3 meter minus 10 millimeter. Okay, and what's the length here? Okay, I'm sorry, it's original, it's 4. Here is 4. So sorry, here is a 5, right? So it's 5. This here is 5 meter plus 20 millimeter. Okay, so if you have length here, if a length A here, and this is a right triangle, so I think you can calculate the length of A prime B. Okay. Okay, so we can just put this. Okay, what's the A prime B? So A prime B is equal to, let's use the same rule. Okay, so it's 3 minus 10 times 10 to the power 3 meters squared plus is 10, 5 plus 20 times 10 to the power minus 3 meters squared. Okay, and what's the length of this? Okay, so you need a calculator. It's 4 plus, is it a 4? Sorry, this is a 4. Okay, then yeah, I checked my notes, I found I make a mistake here. Okay, so this is 4. Okay, this is a 4 here. 4 here is, because here is 4. Yeah, yes, here is 4. Yeah, I really forgot. This is 4. Okay, here is 4. Okay, so here's 4. So let's do the calculation. Okay, when you do this calculation, be careful. Okay, 3 minus 10 times power minus 3. Okay, and square. Okay, and I think 8894. And it's the 4 plus 20 times 10 to the power minus 3 and the square. So it's 16.1604. Okay, and plus 8.9401. Take a square root. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so is equal 1.05004. Okay, when you're quite trying to calculate the strain, my recommendation is I think you have the 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 decimal point, okay, or 6 effective digit. Okay, you need a 5 decimal point, or your calculation is or you cannot find the correct strain. Okay, I will demonstrate this later. Okay, so what is our delta AV? Okay, delta AV is equal to this one minus AB, so it's 0.01004. Okay, so what's the strain AB? Okay, what's the strain AB? So it's 0.01004 divided by 5. So what's the answer? 0.01004 divided by 5. So it's 2.008 times 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, that's this answer for normal strain AB. Okay, if this problem if you just take the two decimal point, if you 5.01, your AB strain AB will be 0.01. And your epsilon AB will be 0.01, 0.05 is 0.01 divided by 5. What? It's 2 times 10 to the power minus 3. For this problem, it doesn't look too bad. Okay, so 2 times 10 to the power minus 3 and 2.008 times the 10 to the power minus 3. That doesn't have that much difference, but I think that's because this is the first problem. Okay, this is a strain AB, and later we will calculate strain for AC. Okay, strain AC, I don't think you can just only take two decimal point. Okay, so next thing we calculate the AC. The strain of AC. So we need to calculate A prime C. Okay, so let's calculate A prime C. Okay, so let's calculate A prime C. So A prime C, the calculation of A prime C and A prime B actually is very similar to each other. Okay, we just use the rule for right triangle. Okay, Pythagoras law. I forget the name of the law. Okay, so this is A prime C. Okay, so let's see A prime C is here. So how to calculate length of A prime C? Yeah, they're very similar. Oh, A prime C here is 3m plus 10 millimeter. And the height, yeah, the same is 4m plus 2 millimeter. Okay, height is the same. Okay, so the length of A prime C is 3 plus 10 times 10 to the power minus 3 square, and plus 10 plus 20 times 10 to the power minus 3 square. Okay, so what's the value here? I think this is the same. Okay, 4 plus 20 times 10 to the power minus 3. I'm sorry, 4 plus 20 times 10 to the power minus 3. And then square. So this, the second one is the same, 1604. And the first one, 3 plus 10 times. And to the power minus 3 and square. So is the same. Did I do something wrong? Okay, so and plus 16.1604. Okay, take a square root. So it's 5.02200. Okay, Okay, so that's A prime C. Okay, so what is the delta AC? Okay, delta AC or delta AC. Delta AC is just minus original length of AC. Original is 5, so it's 0.02200. Okay, so what's the normal strength AC? It's equal to 0.02200 divided by 4. So 0.022 divided by divided by 5, so it's 4.4 times 10 to the power minus 3. Really? Let me see. 0.022200 divided by 5. Yeah, it's 4.4, 10 times 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, did I get it right? Okay, the correct answer is 4.44. Where is this 4.4 comes from? Is this correct? Maybe this is not correct. Yeah, maybe I have one more digit. Okay. And the next thing I want to show, if you use the if you take only take the two digit, you only take two digit. Okay, you take two digit. Okay, so your delta AC will be 0.02. Okay, it's 0.02 divided by 0.02 divided by 5. It will be 0.004. So it's 4 times 10 to the power minus 3. You see the. Yeah, maybe you think it's not a big difference, 4.4 and 4.4, but actually it's 10% difference. Okay, so you have to be aware about that. I said that's already 10% difference. Okay, 4.4 is about 10% difference. So you cannot say there's no difference. It's already 10%. Okay, just like the example we just showed. Okay, the last one example doesn't have the, the last one example there, doesn't have that much difference. Yeah, I think the last one is 2.01 and 2.00, right? 0.002. Yeah, the next one is, I think the last example only has the 1% difference, right? Okay, the last example is 1% difference. But here is in the strength of AC is already 10% difference. So I think you cannot say there is no difference between these two ends. It's already 10%. Okay, but the strength AB, if strength AB, if you take two decimal point, that doesn't affect the answer that much. Okay, but if you for the strength AC, if you use two decimal point or 5 decimal point, you will have the 10% inside of 10% difference. Okay, so that's what I just want to show you. Okay, when you calculate strength, you take more decimal point. That's more safe. Okay, that's more safe when you calculate strength. Maybe this example doesn't have much difference, but I think the next example you will have much difference if you didn't take enough digits, okay, or take enough decimal point. Okay, so I just start the example here. Okay, I'll show the other example in the next video. See you in another video. Bye bye.